Maria Cassini, and I am the Academic Programs Assistant here at the Morris and Helen Belkin Art Gallery. I would like to welcome you all today for the latest edition of the concert at the Belkin in response to our current exhibition, Phil. The concert positions itself within Phil's response, emphasis on embodied practices of knowledge-making and forms of the pedagogy that engage with healing, love, and sustainability as core to their methodologies. Before we begin, I would like to formally acknowledge that we're gathered today on the traditional, ancestral, and unceded territory of the Musqueam Nation. We're honored, privileged, and thankful to the Musqueam Nation and the broader Coast Salish peoples, including the Squamish, Tsleil-Waututh Nation, to be able to study, work, create art, and create music on this land. With many artworks in this Phil exhibition, we invite you to think through our collective and individual relationship to this territory and orient ourselves in relation to the political and economic history of the land. Thank you. Once again, the Belkin Gallery is pleased to welcome the UBC Contemporary Players for a concert inspired by the current exhibition. Directed by UBC School of Music faculty Paolo Bortolussi, the UBC Contemporary Players Ensemble includes graduate and undergraduate students focusing on music and performances of our time. Programs blend masterworks by internationally acclaimed composers with exciting works written expressively for the ensemble by UBC composition majors, alumni, and faculty. So please join me in welcoming UBC School of Music faculty Paolo Bortolussi.
Thank you so much for being here. It's a pleasure to be back here at the Belkin Gallery. It's always exciting every time we perform here because the space is transformed by the exhibits for each particular concert. So each concert has such a specific visual, aural, the shape of the room, the gallery changes, the way the sound bounces around off of the walls and the ceilings and the people changes for every concert that we have here. The first piece you heard today is by Vancouver or Deep Cove composer Jordan Nobles, who writes works, many works, specifically to be spaced out in atriums, in interesting spaces around the city, often places such as the atrium of the main branch of the Public Art Gallery. There's a wonderful concert that they gave in a swimming pool. There was a concert at the Spinal Center, which has a very cool sort of staircase atrium space. He's written pieces, a piece called Museum Pieces, which is meant to be performed in an art gallery, and we performed this at the Kamloops Art Gallery earlier this year. This particular piece I thought was particularly interesting to the space, and it's the first time we've done this, where we completely, I guess, invaded every corner of the gallery. And introduce sort of this interactivity with the space and with the people. So I hope many of you got a chance. Sorry, you're kind of blinded over there.
All the way over here, you can look in this direction.
That you got a chance to walk around and just sort of hear how the sound and the piece was transformed. And because if you turn a corner, suddenly you're hearing a different group of instruments. Suddenly you're hearing a different timbre. And I found that particularly sort of captivating. The program that we have here today is very local. We have works written by our own director of the music school, who is here today, and I'll introduce him a little bit later. We have a work by Stephen Chapman, which was an older work of his, but also one of our faculty composers at UBC. We have a work by Jocelyn Morlock, who many of you will know, who recently was a composer in residence with the Vancouver Symphony and also teaches at the UBC School of Music. We had a work by a student, which was supposed to close the program, and unfortunately I'm going to have to tell you that we can't perform it today because we had a fairly severe illness in the group and someone couldn't attend. So we've had to cancel the last work on your program. I'm going to talk a little bit between each piece, but we're going to change the order slightly so that we are actually going to end with Patrick Carabray's Clear Lake Dusk. Sort of Ouija things as we go. There was one other I was going to mention. Howard Bashaw, who's an alum of UBC, as well. So he is also represented on the show. So we have various sort of levels of connectedness with the UBC School of Music. So I hope you enjoy sort of exploring these works as we go. The second work on the program, you're looking at me like I should say something, but the second work on the program is the duo by Steve Chapman for flute and guitar. They are gonna, it's not on the program, they're gonna present three short movements of this work, the first, fourth, and the fifth, is that correct?
First, fourth, and the fifth.
They use lots of interesting techniques on the flute and the guitar, so I hope you'll enjoy listening to the interesting ways that they sort of interact in this work as well. So I'll invite Shanti-Ella and Phillip onto the stage, into this part of the stage for Chapman's five soliloquy.
Thank you.
So as we're setting up for this next piece, I mentioned that Howard Bashaw is an alum at the UBC School of Music. He now teaches in Edmonton, and I don't want to say too much because it's, I want you to just sort of experience this piece as it goes. The students and the performers of this work have prepared a sort of theatrical spin on the beginning of the work, so I'll let them take that away when the time comes. Sorry, I'm getting in your way. These movements, they're doing four movements of this work, and we've kind of rearranged the order. The movements range, one of them is 20 seconds long, one of them is a minute and 15 seconds long, so they're very brief and quirky. Howard has a particularly dry, interesting sense of humor, which I quite appreciate about him. He has other works, not this one, but some of his works are titled, I think he got frustrated with having to find titles for works, so he started titling them things like 4M, 6P, 3M, which was like 4 minutes, six people, three movements, and things like that. So it would be very sort of mathematical in the way he approached it. The works themselves are not so mathematical. It's a good time to introduce Ramsey Sadaka, who's my wonderful TA and indispensable assistant for Contemporary Players.
Thank you.
The next piece is by Jacinto Chelsea, and I believe we are adding one movement to this one. We are fortunate that they have more than just the two prepared. So they're doing, two, three, and four.
Yes, is that correct?
So it ends now. The one that's not listed on the program is this lovely kind of quirky, almost folk dance. Very early work for Chelsea, and those of you know who his later works will see a lot of what ideas he develops later in his career. He's very sort of pitch-centric, playing with the tones and timbres overlapping, pulling away from tonal centers, collapsing back into them. But you also find this also sort of Bartokian influence earlier on in the last movement of the picture. So we're close to ready-ish, almost. Yeah. I will invite Emily and Samuel onto the stage to perform Chelsea's duo.
Thank you.
next piece in the program, as you can see, is a lovely duo. This is only one movement from Vespertine, the second movement of a beautiful sort of slow, sort of a lyrical piece called Verdigris. Thank you, Jocelyn. Jocelyn's in the house right now. We're fortunate to have so many of our composers that we get to interact with and meet on a daily basis in the School of Music, so it's been a treat to feature so many of them on today's program. So I think we're set. We're all set. And I'll invite Nathania and Joyce out to the stage to perform. Casimir, who's over there sitting. Thank you so much for your work. We didn't acknowledge you in the audience, so thank you very much. We're also fortunate to have Patrick Carabray in the audience tonight, so I asked you beforehand if you'd be willing to come and say a couple words about your piece before we heard it. Now's a good time to do that. So thank you very much for being here, Patrick Carabray.
This piece was commissioned by the Clear Lake Chamber Music Festival. It's one of Canada's lovely summer festivals, and it was for their 10th anniversary. It takes place in and around Clear Lake in Manitoba, which is in Riding Mountain National Park. So like Canada's many national parks, gorgeous, beautiful place where families gather. There are lots of cottages, summer activities. And this, I kind of envisioned the time just as the sun's going down, you've had your dinner, it's probably 1 o'clock, and time to enjoy the beauty and think about family and all those things. Clear Lake was actually, Manitoba has 100,000 lakes, so a lot of area in which one can spend time with water, and it's great to be in the show that the room where the spill exhibition is going on, which draws lots of attention to important issues around water. In Manitoba, most of those 100,000 lakes were the result of glaciation and the fallout from the melt of the Wisconsin glacier. But Clear Lake is actually a meteor strike. So it's very deep in one place, and then the spill off from that, the cast off, created this very shallow lake on the other side. So it's very deep on one side, shallow on the other, cottages all around. So just imagine, like I said, you're enjoying this beautiful landscape and continuing on the hopefully the beautiful melodic ideas that Jocelyn presented in her piece. So this is hopefully a happy, enjoyable, relaxing piece. Thank you.
you all for coming. Thank you to Shelley and the team at the Belkin Gallery. Thank you, Patrick, Jocelyn, for your works. We look forward to seeing you again next semester at the Belkin on Friday, if you care for it, at noon at Barnett Hall at the School of Music. We're also performing, again, a slightly different program than this one. So thanks again for coming today.